can't say. You give back to me a smile and the pouring rain.
My leather chair was holding my butt in a tight grip. It felt borderline homoerotic, but I was man enough to take it. The sign on my door said, "Knock, you bastard." Frank Mitchell never says please unless followed by the demand of his subject to die. Frank Mitchell is the kind of man that takes what he wants, and right now he wants another donut. Frank Mitchell took the donut while thinking about his everyday actions in third person. Frank Mitchell takes his coffee like he'd take penis if he was a gay man with jungle fever, strong and black. Coffee that puts the darkest of Middle Eastern blood oil to shame. Darker than the night wrapped in black plastic bags, put in a matte black 64 Camaro and shot in the face with a black market assault rifle. But this specific morning, Frank Mitchell had a little cream and a little sugar in his coffee. Cases had come and gone, but at the moment it was particularly slow. No damsels in distress, no bodies in the river, and no cats in trees. For a moment I thought the world had gone straight and law-abiding, but I knew better than that. This was the calm before the storm, the aim before the shot, the lubrication before the violent ramming of the anus. The ship was going to hit the fan, and the fan was an industrial-strength 12-foot propeller, and the shit was a month's worth of latrine storage from a German camping site. My daydreaming was brought to an abrupt halt as the phone suddenly woke me from my thoughts. After staring at it for a solid 2 minutes, and subsequently hitting it with my fist a couple of times for good measure, I picked up. Not even a 2,000-year-old biblical prophecy could have prepared me for what I was going to hear at the other end of the putrid phone line. A voice full of contempt and dread. What was talking to me was the shell of a human being, long lost in his own personal hell.
"Hello?"
the voice said in an awfully cheery tone.
"Do you have a minute?"
I was contemplating different witty comebacks. I could have initiated a philosophical discussion about who is entitled to time and whether or not we have control over how the remainder of our lives are spent. Is human free will but an illusion, and everything that happens only the result of previous events and thoughts? Or I could have simply played it cool, like I have a tendency to do, and strike the caller with awe through a fascinating analogy. "Yes," I replied, while feeling like I could have had a better response.
"I'm calling from Karma East Asian Supplements. I would like to interest you in a subscription to our Omega-3 pills. They're only $15 a month, and we'll even throw in a compact resting pillow that's perfect for travel."
My blood was a highly explosive fluid, and its words were the catalyst that sets off the chemical reaction. My heart froze and burned simultaneously, and my brain was knocking on the inside of my skull, wanting to get out and book a charter flight straight into the sun. "Well, I'm not sure if I'm interested."
"If you're not sure now, I can send you the welcome promo package, and you can make the decision in the comfort of your own home."
"Okay," I hear myself say. I hated myself for it.
"Thank you, sir. The package will arrive at your current address in a few days. Have a good day."
"Thank you," I said. I felt dirty. I wasn't able to stand up to him. "I am Frank Mitchell. I single-handed brought down one of the largest Colombian cartels. I exposed the corruption in some of the world's largest companies when nobody else would take the risk. I put at least 4,000 people behind bars and thereby helped take their anal virginity. I once shot a man in the foot and his head exploded. I'm fucking Frank Mitchell. And now I'm gonna get a welcome promo package of Omega-3 pills from Karma East Asian Supplements, Incorporated, and a compact resting pillow that's perfect for travel. I'm going to take a nap on the couch for a bit. A very manly nap."
DeadHorseInterchange.com